Good afternoon. If I may have your attention, I'm Father O'Leary, and before I give my little words, I'd like to welcome all of you here, and Cardinal Sean O'Malley would like to address you as well.
Thank you very much, Monsignor. Good afternoon, everyone. Just wanted to say a word of welcome to all of you who have gathered here today for this concert and those who are watching on live stream. We're so delighted to be able to host this. We're grateful to Monsignor O'Leary for all of his leadership here at the Cathedral. Our cathedrals throughout the world have always been centers of culture, of learning, of works of mercy, and of course a place where people in the community gather to express their faith, to worship God, and to form a community of brothers and sisters. This cathedral has been doing that for 150 years. Pope Francis tells us that the best way to announce the good news is through the way of beauty, the via pulchritudinis, because it's in the beauty of the art, the music, that we discover God's beauty and love for us. And so we're so grateful to all of you, for our musicians and all of those who will be taking part in the concert today. May this be a moment for us to reflect on God's beauty and to give thanks for the community that brings us together here today. God bless all of you. Thank you once again for your support and your presence here today.
Again, thank you, Cardinal Sean. For some of you, it may be your first time here, or it may be one of your first live concerts in a long time. And as I said, we're thrilled to have you with us. We are very fortunate to have this great organ here in Boston, a landmark instrument in American organ building. Organists from all over the country make a point of visiting us here at the Cathedral to see and hear the 1875 E. Hook and Hastings organ. We are grateful for the transformed acoustic that allows its original beauty to shine. As you can see, got rid of the rugs. So many of you appreciate the great beauty and dignity of the pipe organ, which lends also to the sacred liturgy. Vatican Council said, in the Latin Church, the pipe organ is to be held in high esteem, for it is the traditional musical instrument which adds a wonderful splendor to the Church's ceremonies and powerfully lifts up our mind and hearts to God and to higher things. Those are not mere words, but they are an expression of the importance of that beauty plays in worship today, especially in a world hungry for meaning and transcendence. Along with transformed acoustic from the 2019 renovation came a transformed use of the cathedral pipe organ. During the last 2 years especially, the cathedral has relied exclusively upon its 145-year-old pipe organ for every liturgy. It's played at every mass, wedding, and funeral. It has been heard on Catholic TV broadcasts by millions all over the globe. The fruit of this shift is apparent. The pipe organ brings greater joy, energy, and beauty to the sacred liturgy and accompanies the choir more readily. It leads us in song more heartily. The cathedral pipe organ is an important part of our community, and we are grateful that our diverse community is growing. As such, we are deeply grateful for our generous donors who help us keep the instrument maintained. Many of you have given most generously many, many times. We are truly grateful as we make very most of your contributions. But as you can imagine, there is still a great deal more work to be done. While its mechanical needs are deeply pressing, we don't want to be fooled by how wonderful it sounds today. Many parts date to 1875. Internal electronics are 100 years old, as the organ was electrified in the 1920s. To keep up with the busy liturgical and TV schedule, repair visits are all too frequent, requiring service several times per month. We need it to work reliably every day and for the future. As the cathedral looks to its 150th anniversary, which coincides with the 150th anniversary of this extraordinary organ. We fully intend to restore the instrument before then, and hopefully much sooner. As always, we owe a great debt of gratitude to Music Director Emeritus Leo Abbott. His tenacious work to resurrect an instrument that was nearly unplayable when he arrived here in 1986 was nothing short of heroic. Today we celebrate not just history and tradition of the cathedral organ. We celebrate because the Holy Spirit makes all things new. Today's concert offers not only beautiful classics, but new music as well, including three world premieres by a new generation of composers. And so we read in Mark's Gospel, "Therefore every scribe instructed concerning the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings out of his storeroom treasures new and old." Again, thank you for coming this day. Please enjoy these extraordinary musicians.
Thank you. Welcome, and thank you for coming. I'm Richard Clark. The piece was dedicated to the memory of Gina Geer. The piece was dedicated to Billy Geer and Gina. Billy was her father. She died earlier this year, and someone that taught us great wisdom. The next person is the reason we're all here, and the person I thank every morning when I come here at about 7:30 after dropping my kids off at school. I practice and I thank this man every day I'm here. Leo Abbott, please welcome. I get to turn pages. I have the best seat in the house for that performance. Check out the live stream later on for those who are here in person. It's fantastic. Our next performer is a great champion of new music, an incredible composer himself, and so generous in performing so many works of others. Today we have two world premieres, one by Melissa Dunphy and Howard Skempton. Please check out also Carson Kuman's website, carsonkuman.com. He has tons of these videos on YouTube. He's very generous and has graced us with so many fantastic performances and exposes us to so much great new music. Please welcome Carson Kuman. our next performer, Janet Hunt, Dr. Janet Hunt, not only an extraordinary organist and harpsichordist. One of the things that you may not be aware of, she's bringing to light a lot of fantastic music from the 17th century and a lot of early music. She digs through and discovers these gems and has been doing wonderful additions. You definitely want to check out her website, huntmusic.us, huntmusic.us. So she's bringing all this great music, not just the new music that comes to light, it's a lot of old music that comes to light, and we're deeply grateful to her on that. And also an extraordinary performer. We're so glad to have her back, and please give a warm welcome to Dr. Janet Hunt.
Thank you.
Our next performer, certainly a rising star, we're so happy to have him here in Boston. A prolific composer at a young age has accomplished quite a number of things. He is now the organist where I spent about 3 decades at St. Cecilia Church in Boston. I'm just so thrilled to hear what he's doing. Check out his YouTube, Thomas Mellon on YouTube. A lot of great, amazing things to check out there. But I'm just so thrilled to hear what he's doing with the Smith & Knobscott organ that I worked very hard to have built, expanded, maintained, continually used, and Thomas has taken it even to another level. I really appreciate that. We are also blessed to have our third world premiere tonight, his very own symphonic nocturne, and the work commemorates the 200th anniversary of the birth of César Franck in 1822. We're so blessed to have it here at the Cathedral. Please welcome Thomas Mellon. Thank you so much for being here. Carson had to leave early. He's got a concert at King's Chapel, so he had to run. Thank you for being here. If anyone wants to take a look at the console, come on up. The doorway is unlocked. And please come again. If you feel you didn't donate enough money and you thought the music was so awesome that you just have to give more, please do. But thank you so much. And you can also check out again, if you want to enjoy this again, check out the live stream, share it with your friends, and come on back. Thank you. Good to see you all.